Robert, let me ask you this. Fernando used to live with you guys, right?
He lived with
what
us.
Was that like?
Yes, we slept in the same fucking bed. It was a little...
How old were you guys?
Hey. Young, dude, young. He was 12, 13. That was 14, 15. No, dile a tu mami, dile a tu mami.
No,
no.
He was listening.
No.
When he followed his dad, he was perfect. I mean, everything was good for him.
Hey. How you doing, Alvin?
He's like, ready?
Hey, no, come on. You know, hey, my dad took him over. My dad, he knows, man. He calls my dad jefe. He knows. He calls me. I talk to him. He's like, hey, how's my jefe? You know, we talk and everything. And
what is jefe? What is jefe?
Jefe like that. How's my dad? Yeah. And he calls my dad. He says, jefe, ¿cómo está? Jefe, you don't follow him on Twitter?
Yes.
My jefe said.
Yeah, I just talked to my jefe.
Yeah.
But he's a cool dude.
He's all religious, helpful.
Huh?
He's all religious.
Yeah.
So we always see him. Yeah.
He's religious now.
Yeah, we see on Twitter. He tweets about going to church.
Why don't you go to church?
Huh? I don't know. I don't know.
I see. Right there.
Nah, I said it. I went at the same, and it actually felt good.
So what do you remember the most from Fernando as a young boxer? Just the beast.
Before my dad started giving him rides to the gym, we would be driving to the gym, and he lived over here in the south, College States, which is 4 miles from La Colonia gym. And we used to be driving to the gym, and we see that little kid right there running with his little brother in the back.
Roger,
yeah, running to the gym. And then we would get there, they show up all sweaty, train, and then run. And then at night when we're driving back home, there goes those little kids. So my dad started talking to them. When my dad started talking to them, it was a few weeks, maybe a few months, that my dad never even, because there was, there's so many kids that go and leave. So my dad never paid attention to them. And one day my dad says, there was another three coaches there. Tells the coaches, each of you guys pick one of the fighters. There was three fighters, same age, same weight. Fernando, there was some guy we called Lizard, and I don't remember the third one.
Lizard.
I remember. Well, it was three of them, okay?
Yeah.
And my dad tells the other three coaches, you guys pick whichever one you want. Give me the leftover, and we're all gonna train them for a few months and see who does better. So Fernando was the kid that they didn't believe in, because I remember him sparring a few times. He would get hit and he would turn his back, but he just had no instructions, no guidance. He was just a street boy that he got hit and he didn't know what to do, so he would just turn. Never, nobody ever worked mitts with him. Nobody taught him a jab, so
they didn't see the potential.
So yeah, so my dad tells him, you guys pick whichever one you guys want. So the first coach picks one, the second coach picks the other one, and they leave Fernando to my dad. My dad didn't pick.
Sounds like a movie, huh? You should have a movie.
But what if one of the other trainers would have picked Fernando?
Huh?
What if your dad? What if somebody else would have picked Fernando?
Then my dad would have taken the other kid and maybe made the other kid a star.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it was something Fernando already had. So that's how it happened. So my dad starts working with Fernando. So little by little, Fernando starts kicking their ass and starts competing, winning fights. And the first fight that he lost, I remember Fernando came out of the ring for 2 or 3 days. He wouldn't stop crying, and he was so mad because he lost. He felt that he did something wrong to my dad, maybe lost the fight. He was so upset and kept training. Fucker made it to the Olympics. Everybody was after Fernando, man. I'm telling you, everybody was after Fernando.
But then he stayed with your dad after the Olympics.
And then he was getting into some trouble in the street. Family problems, sister problems. Yeah, Fucker's a movie.
Why Fucker is a movie right now?
But he's very popular. Robert, when he goes to fights, hundreds of fans chase him, and he stops and gives everybody autographs and pictures.
Yeah.
I've never seen him be rude to anybody.
He would put on the best show, I think. Everything he would do.
Just the way the fights, the press conferences that he always did.
I would come down different shows, all cocky. That shit was bad.
Did you tell him to bleach the hair?
No, he had it. He started doing it.
Hey, he started. No one had that. He's the one that started. And everyone in Oxnard had that. Everyone in Oxnard had it.
The whole United States.
Everyone had it. In Mexico,
they had it.
No, that was
like.
You remember?
It was great.
Hey, I remember all the Rebels had that. Remember those Rebels?
They would let go of the band right here, and then die, and then,
the Rebels had that shit. I remember that shit.
But he made his mark. He made history. Youngest middleweight champion, right? Ever?
Youngest ever. Man. Only 14 fights.
I am the
youngest ever junior middleweight champion of the world.
Stay tuned for more. FitUsTheReport.com. I'm Ali Sekpak reporting. You can follow me on Twitter @Sekpak.